Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
About 15 miles away from the south shores of Lake Michigan, in South Bend, Indiana. See how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Notre Dame's coaching staff, the fans, I think everybody's been waiting to see this kid play, and here he is.
Well, he's a star quarterback. He seems to bring everything to the table. The crowd, I think, senses he's ready to have a big day. And when your star quarterback feels good at playing at home and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
Here's the pitch, and now the ball is free, and the defense is on it. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. They work hard, and they got the turnover.
Well, this is what it's all about, defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
Nice run up the middle. That'll bring up second and three. From the 7-yard line, second down. He's tackled right around the 4-yard line. And they get the first down.
Just a simple give to the fullback, and he gets enough for the first.
And he adds the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The Jayhawks had a spot in the top 20. That is in jeopardy after this performance. And for Duke, their season starts with a win. The Blue Devils take it by 6. In other games, checking out the action in Cincinnati, it felt as if the game rested on every play. And for Prater, solid, not spectacular, better than 150 yards passing. The Bearcats pull it off by 2.
And for the Panthers, with that final now in, they know they can move up in the polls if they pull out a victory today. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Pittsburgh's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
They coughed up the pigskin the last time they had the ball. Let's see if they can hold on to it this time.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football. What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Second down and around 1 yard to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Going right to his tailback. Tackle at about the 45. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Got it. And he goes down quickly. That's a 7-yard gain.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
It's second and 3. Ball on the 48-yard line. Let's go, defense.
he's at the 20. The 10. Shows some moves and he's in.
I can guarantee you'll be seeing that one in the highlight reels. What a great, great run. A real display of all the tools that he brings to the table.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A four-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
They get a tie game at 7-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. From his own goal line. Gets to about the 17-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Makes it out to about the 26. That's a D. That brings up second and one. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Taken down around the 34-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
And they make the stop at the 33-yard line. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. He makes his way to about the 45. That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10. There's a strike complete. And he's tackled at the 50-yard line. That'll make it second and four. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Gets to about the 47-yard line. They're one of the loudest crowds in the country, and they are on their feet. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
That's a loss of 4 yards. That makes it second and 14.
From their own 16-yard line, it's second down. And down he goes, around the 16-yard line.
That brings up third and 14.
Another run. Up the middle for a nice gain. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Carter awaiting the return. takes it out to about the 47-yard line.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Slings it out there incomplete.
I wouldn't be surprised if this one is offensive pass interference.
Pass interference. Defense.
And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chance to win if they commit too many.
From midfield, first down. He picks it up. Brought down at the 48.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. They can't hear a thing down there. Caught with room to work. And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line.
Gain of 7 yards. First down.
He gets another carry. Tackle made at the 39. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
We've played one. We're even at 7 in this one. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. And he's tackled after positive yardage. They'll line it up again on third down. Rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
This unit has quick hands, and they showed it there by knocking away the pass.
Pittsburgh is looking to go up by 3. Kicks away, and he just drilled it from long range. To kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They'll bring him down at the 27.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
It's second and 8. Ball on their own 27.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Yeah, Black 80. Motion, 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 motion.
Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen.
I don't know what game plan this offense is running, but it might need to be reassessed by this coaching staff.
The defense decided to go conservative, sitting back in cover three. They wanted to make sure the receiver was not going to get open past the first down line on that play.
He's tackled at the 33.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Pittsburgh is up a field goal. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
The misdirection play gets him 4 yards.
That makes it second and six.
Second down and six.
Ball on the 37. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of two.
The crowd really making it difficult. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
The back gets three on the carry.
That makes it fourth and inches.
Callahan will be the return man. Oh, excellent punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Get to that quickly. And he's taken down right around the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line. Second down. Shut it down.
Loss of 6 yards. That brings up third and 14.
Fires out to his receiver. He's to the 40. Across midfield. He's tackled around the 45-yard line. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Hit immediately.
That brings up second and nine.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And here's another third down. Catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
That makes it first and 10.
He gets out to about the 17-yard line. They tossed it to the running back, and he took it about 8 yards. Notre Dame's going to take their first time out of the half.
2 minutes left in the half.
Mike 56.
run, and he's brought down.
The offense coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executed. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
He fights forward to about the 13.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
From the 13-yard line, second down. Makes a move, and he's in for the touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 22. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. The grab, and he's got the first. Great concentration to pull it in.
He is such a good target, really anywhere on the field, but they like to get him the ball in short to medium range situations.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Catches it, and that's all.
Nothing flashy at all. But now, that first down marker is a lot closer.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 47. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
From the 36-yard line, second down. Quick pass. The Panthers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Alston picks up only about 2 yards with that grab. Here comes the pressure. Steps up in the pocket, and he throws right away. Tackle at about the 17-yard line. To go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Notre Dame's gotten the play out of their quarterback, and you expect that that was going to happen. But, I mean, what is happening here? Somebody else is going to have to come to the forefront, or this thing's going to be over.
If you would have told me before the game that this quarterback would have played like this through the first quarter and a half or so, I would have thought this team would have been leading this game. And you're right. Something has got to happen where his teammates, the rest of this group, they've got to raise their game if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
Runs with it, and he's got room. He's at midfield, and they make the stop at the 45. Slings it. He's taken down at about the 35. Notre Dame will use their final timeout. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball in the 35. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. He wants it all, going long. Can't connect.
Callahan was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Goes downtown. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. We played a half of football. The Fighting Irish lead, 21-17.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Neither team has allowed a sack in this game. While a lot of fans, and look, we've been guilty of it in here sometimes as we watch games from around the country, your eye sort of follows the ball. You want to see what happens. But then there's the game inside the game. What's it like in the trenches, offensive line versus defensive line, particularly when one side's winning every time, in this case, the offensive line?
Well, it's always tough to judge because you could be doing your job just fine, but because the secondary doesn't play well, maybe it's just you're doing your job, but the secondary's not, and you look really bad on the same token. But, you know, it's the most physical spot on the field. You get your hands on those big, fat guys every single time, and you got to shed them, and you got to push them back, and you exert a lot of force and a lot of energy, and it's not on defense. You just try to see ball, get ball. You know, offensive, those offensive linemen, they got a little bit more brains to them. They know where they're going. They know where the play is. They know the snap count. It's a little bit easier for them.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Pitches it, and he's hitting the backfield. Second and 14. Ball on the 15-yard line. And he's tackled at the 18. So the old counter gets 2, maybe 3 yards. Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. I'd say that went about as well as the defense hoped it would.
It did a pretty good job of not letting the offense get much going on that possession.
Callahan awaiting the return. It's away and it's a booming punt. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
So we're just about ready to return to action. Notre Dame is up 4. Fires to his fullback. No good. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Up the middle for a nice game. Complete. He's got room. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line, it's first down. He fights forward to about the 46. To convert here on another third down. Brought down at the 42. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
Carter is back to receive. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Notre Dame's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Nice run there as they work the outside. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And down he goes around the 39-yard line.
Gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Run there.
That makes it second and six.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on their own 43.
Down,
pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 47-yard line.
First down.
From the 46-yard line, second down. Runs it right, nice pickup.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver. And he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Go with the back, and he's hammered in the backfield.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
From the 18-yard line, it's second down. He gets to about the 5. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line. They're at the 6. Second down. Here's a pitch, left side. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it 30 goal.
So at the end of 3, the Fighting Irish lead 21-17. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. One of the top stadiums in the nation, this crowd comes to play themselves. Touchdown, and that's going to give them the lead. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So we're early in the fourth quarter, still a lot of football left, but in a game this tight, every possession is going to make a difference. Potter takes it left. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Zips it to the tight end. He's tackled around the 34-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He's at the 40. He's pushed out of bounds
at about the 39-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
From the 39-yard line, first down. They'll drop him for a loss. Slings it out there, incomplete.
That makes it third and 11.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29.
Let's go, D. Let's go.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's taken down at about the 33-yard line.
It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Roger, roger. Mike 56, Mike 56. And watch that. And
throws it in a hurry, and no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds.
I really thought the defense had a chance to get their hands on it, but the ball went out of bounds first. That's got to be disappointing.
From the 12-yard line, first down. Taken down in the backfield.
He knew it was on all the way and got a good jump. He got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
10th play of the drive.
Come tight, come tight. Go down, go down. 26 by 86. Yeah, 99.
Here comes the pressure. They'll bring him down at the 5. About 4 yards away here on third down.
Mike 56, Mike 56.
My switch.
Yeah. Black 8.
Gets it out. He's met immediately. That's a loss of 4 yards.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start. But you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it go.
He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Here's an update from the studio and restate.
The Tigers were ranked 19th. Another W might have them moving up the charts with a bullet. And for California, they've lost two in a row. The Tigers win it, 24-20.
All right, Reese, back to our game. Notre Dame to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 25. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital.
Go, 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 go.
takes it out to about the 39. From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. They'll get him for a loss. Just under three to go in regulation. Caught, and that's a first down. Tackle at the 30-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Three down. Easy.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. Taken down right around the 20.
Number 10 makes the tackle at the 20-yard line.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. And they make the stop at the 11.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That brings up second and 1.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
Gain of 5 on the play. That makes it first.
Here's the 8th play of the series. And he's tackled at the 4-yard line. Just inside the 5. Second down. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. They go to the ground game. Touchdown, Pitt! Tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 31-24. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Notre Dame's coaches have got to be confident in the fact that they've got a star player in a tight situation.
And there's nothing better than having a quarterback you have confidence in these kind of situations. You know he's going to make the right read. He's going to give his receivers a chance to make a play on the ball. And they're going to have a really good chance of moving the ball down the field to have a shot to win this game.
Fires it out. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line. He's had a good game, snaring passes for 100 yards.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
And he's tackled in the open field. They got 4 yards on that one.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. So they'll have one last shot here to possibly tie this game up. They'll need their prayers to be answered if they don't want to lose this one. Doesn't get there. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 31-24, Pittsburgh. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action in this one?
You wouldn't figure either team would pull away, and it'd go right down to the very end. This was a really exciting matchup. Pittsburgh made the plays they had to win this game. And that's what it often comes down to with two evenly matched teams. Whoever comes through in the clutch gets the W.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.